It's so interesting to see that. Thank you. To see the hyperscalers so focused on this. I think we start with why SMRs, right? That's a very specific avenue to go down.
Yeah, I think SMRs are a great new technology, and they're an important part of the energy landscape that we're looking at. We made a $500 million investment in a company called X Energy that are really, I think they're one of the leaders in this space, and they're really pushing on the technology. SMRs, they have a couple of advantages. They're able to be constructed in a smaller footprint, which means you can put them closer to where the energy needs to be. They're also incredibly safe and easily manufacturable. And so they're a very promising technology, and we're quite excited about our investments in this space and the partnerships that we have coming up.
Small modular reactors, SMRs, for those getting in the acronym lingo. Matt, it's great to have you. What about other deals? I mean, is this the first of many?
Yeah, and so a couple of details on the things that we announced yesterday. One, we have this investment with X Energy, who's a producer of these, but we also have announced two partnerships with utilities. And so we're actually well down the path on going and actually implementing some of these deals. So we have a partnership with Dominion in Virginia to go implement an SMR as part of their energy footprint here in Virginia, and with Energy Northwest in Washington and Oregon. And our goal is to deliver more than 5 gigawatts of nuclear energy. We think that it's a fantastic opportunity for us to keep pushing on the carbon energy footprint that's needed as we continue to scale around the country.
Matt, if you're well down the path and based on what you just said, do you have a clear line of sight on what the dollar per megawatt hour is going to be out of those facilities?
We don't know that yet. We are still early, and we're still learning. Many of these technologies for these reactors probably won't come online until 2030. So we'll still be learning there. But we feel that as we scale and in the fullness of time, these energy sources are going to be quite competitive from a cost perspective. And it's one of the reasons that we're so excited about them.
Would you bring back a full nuclear plant like Three Mile Island in Pennsylvania? And if so, which one?
I wouldn't have done that one in particular, but we actually have a partnership with Talen where we're bringing more energy online in Pennsylvania. And that's we're actually the very first company to announce a deal with Talen several months ago. And so I think that some of these large nuclear plants are also excellent sources of energy, and they're an important part of that. And as I said, I think small modular reactors are going to be a component of what we need for a carbon-free energy world. But large nuclear plants are going to be an important part of that too. And we've said that we'll take as much as almost a gigawatt of power that we're bringing back online from this large plant in Pennsylvania, where we'll also be building data centers nearby. So I think it's an important part of the portfolio as we move to decarbonize the energy.
Let's talk about the decarbonization, because back when you announced that deal in March with Susquehanna, you talked about how still the aim is to be, by 2025, 100% renewable energy. Is that attainable with a sudden desire to have AI and the energy that goes with it?
Yeah, in fact, we announced that this year we hit 100% carbon-free energy in our systems. And I think that now our goal is, how do we, as we look at all of the energy demands that the business and the world, frankly, needs, how do we get to a continued path on growing carbon-free energy? And so that's what a lot of these deals are about, is for the future, as we look at power that we're going to need in 25, 27, 30, 2040, how do we make sure that we have a ramp of power so that as the energy needs grow, whether they're from electric vehicles or from companies increasingly digitizing or from generative AI, that we have enough carbon-free energy to support them. And so it's really a long-term view that we have. And part of this is on that long-term view, how we continue to have enough power well into the future.
Let's talk about the short-term view, if we can, for a minute, Matt, though, because right here, right now, do you have the power that is necessary from the places you want to be getting it from?
We work really hard to make sure that we do. Our business is continuing to grow rapidly, and we're adding new power and new data centers all of the time. And so we look further out. We have power that we're adding in 24, power that we're adding in 2025, and continue out. And as you may have heard, over the last 5 years, Amazon has been the single biggest purchaser of renewable power contracts in the world every year for the last 5 years. And so we continue to do that. We continue to add power to our footprint. And we plan multiple years out, because these projects that we go and launch, they take many years to come online. And so we have lots of plans, and we continue to grow as the needs of our customers grow.
Matt, will you have any Blackwell online by the end of this year?
No, unfortunately, NVIDIA's timelines have shifted on that. And so we have samples in the lab and we're working on them right now, but production quantities, we expect to be early next year. We work very closely with NVIDIA on GPUs and super excited about that launch. And NVIDIA's own large research cluster is actually launching in AWS. So we'll have the first production qualities will be in AWS when they're ready. But right now we're working with them and we have early samples, but as they get their yields up on the respin of the Blackwell chip, it'll probably be early next year before we really get production samples in real volume.
Another partnership then, Anthropic's work on the chips. How is that going, briefly?
Fantastic. Anthropic continues to deliver fantastic new models. Their Sonnet 3.5 model is one of the most powerful ones that is out there today, and customers are really enjoying using it on a variety of tasks. I think the reasoning is industry and world class, and a bunch of the capabilities that enterprises are able to deliver and the value they get from those models is really right. It's fun to watch, and we really enjoy that partnership, and we continue to expect it to go for a long time.